If I had to learn from scratch how to code again, this is some of the tips that I would use to do so. Things that I wish I knew when I was first learning how to code. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for your comments, questions, feedback. You know, I love you all so much. Okay, let's just get right into it. I remember when I was first learning how to code, one of the biggest things that I kept on running into was there is so much to learn. I felt like it was never ending, all the new things that I had to learn. Tech is huge and it's changing so quickly. The thought of being able to catch up to it or to be ahead of it seemed impossible. Every time I felt like I was getting ahead on something or learning a new framework, it would be the next framework would come out that's more popular or changes to the framework would happen. And it just made it feel like I would never catch up. One of my biggest tips or pieces of advice if I was to learn code all over again or start from scratch would be to not obsess over what framework or programming language to learn. Now, I know this might seem kind of controversial in the sense of, well, Tiff, I need to know which one to choose to, in order to get a job, which one is in demand. You're already thinking too much. At the end of the day, pick a very popular programming language or framework to learn. And even if the jobs that you are looking for require a different language or framework, they're not going to completely nix you out of the candidate or process when they are looking to hire just because you don't know that specific language. Trust me, as someone who has been on the hiring side as well, if someone knows Python and we are hiring for a JavaScript developer, we're not going to completely write off the person who knows Python, not at all. We know if you can learn one programming language, you can easily pick up another. And same goes with frameworks. Sorry, it's starting these days, it's kind of weird. Pick a programming language and just stick to it. That's my biggest piece of advice. Don't just start learning something and then switch to another programming language or another framework before you have really mastered the first one. And that brings me to my second tip, which is ask for help. I feel like, especially as beginners, way too often we put off asking for help in fear of looking silly or stupid, this is something that we should know the answer to. When in reality, no one is expecting you to have it all figured out when you are learning something new. Actually, let me rephrase that. No one is expecting you to have it all figured out ever. And if they are, clearly they have their expectations completely out of line, and because it's so unrealistic because tech is changing so quickly. So often I would put off asking questions out of fear of looking silly, and it would really slow down my growth. And this is something that it's a fine line when to know if you were asking too many questions, if you didn't spend enough time researching it, like how do you know when is the right time to ask a question? Which I think is a skill in itself, especially when it comes to tech roles, because did I do enough Googling? Did I Google the right things? Should I ask this person a question? And I'll give you a little insight as to my process when I am asking questions. What I first do if I'm stuck on something is, of course, Google it. Break down the question and Google it. Before I Google it, I will actually break down the question. And it sounds so silly, but oftentimes I find if I actually speak to a fake rubber ducky, then it will actually really help me understand what is the problem I am trying to solve. It really highlights just how often I actually don't even know what problem I'm trying to solve, and I think that's a very common thing. We think we know the problem we are trying to solve, but when we actually voice it out loud and say, I am trying to solve this defect in the code because it is causing this button to break or whatever it is, when you actually step back and reassess why you are trying to solve this problem and what the problem is, it gives you a much clearer understanding as to what to do next. And what I mean by that is even what to Google next. From there, I will start Googling my heart out, going to Stack Overflow, trying different terms, different ways I'm Googling. I feel like I'm saying Googling a lot, but Googling is really an art, and it's something that the more you do it, the more you will get better at it and get more comfortable with it. So you just need to start. If I kind of give myself a specific amount of time to Google something, and after that period of time, if I'm still stuck, then I will go to help or ask for help. And when I ask for help, I do it very specifically. I go to the senior person that I am supposed to ask questions to, and I really break down the question I have. So this is the problem I'm trying to solve. This is what I have tried to do as far as Googling or solutions implemented, and this is still the outcome I am having. And when you really break down the problem that way and ask a question in a way that the senior person understands what the problem is, what you have Googled and what you have tried, it makes it much easier for them to A, want to help you, and B, have a clear understanding of what the problem is. They're just getting, you know, notice of this problem firsthand from you. They haven't spent days on it or a day on it or hours on it like you have. So you really need to break it down clearly for them. Also, I really think this makes you a better developer because it shows that you can communicate in a really efficient way. And that brings me to my third tip, which is, it sounds kind of silly, but when I was first learning how to code, or if I could start all over again, I would tell myself to be kind to myself. I feel like when I was first learning how to code, I was so hard on myself. I think it's because I wanted a job, of course, but I would put so much unrealistic pressure on myself that, hey, Tiff, if you don't have this mastered by this point, you are never going to get a job, you're never going to make money. And it was just so stressful, the amount of pressure I put on myself. So if anyone out there is learning how to code, you're watching this video and you're doing that as well by putting all that unnecessary pressure, take a step back, speak to yourself how you would speak to your friends. I really want to highlight that because we are often so much harder on ourselves than we are on others, or we speak to ourselves the way we would never speak to anyone else. And I really just wanted to include that point because it's really important. I think, you know, when you're learning how to code, learning this new skill, it's a whole new world, and it's easy to get caught up in, I'm never going to learn it, or I'm not smart enough. My tip for that is, if, you know, millions of other people did it, so can you. And that really helped carry me through as well, is recognizing that so many people have learned to code before. I'm not unique. And if they can do it, why can't I? And that really kind of helped boost my confidence a bit. My fourth tip on the list is to recognize it's impossible to know everything. We kind of touched on this earlier, and I think it's so important to really highlight as its own tip, because when you're first entering the tech industry, it feels like you need to know everything. I need to know, be an expert on this or be an expert on that. And in reality, no, you don't. You need to know a little about a lot of things. Now, I'm not talking about being a generalist here, although you can go that route too. But, you know, even if you want to be a specialist, meaning really focus in or hone in on one technology, having insight and knowledge as to other technologies out there, now you don't need to spend time on them or anything like that, but understanding as to when certain technologies are used for certain things, I think will really make you a better developer or any role in tech, really, by understanding technology as a whole. And my last tip is, when I was starting to code, and I kind of touched on this earlier, but stop jumping around and trying to be an expert so quickly. Focus on the fundamentals. I was so excited when I first started to learn how to code that rather than learning really, really the basics and having a strong understanding of those, I quickly went to React, I went to Vue, I went to Express, Node. I was so excited, and I was like, oh, whatever, I'll learn the basics later. But in turn, it really slowed down my growth later in my coding career, because fine, I knew all these really cool frameworks or languages, but I didn't really understand why we use them, the fundamentals of them, how they worked, kind of what was going on behind the scenes. And that made it harder to debug and to find or implement solutions that were best for the code base. So if you are learning how to code, once again, make sure you really go back to the basics and have an understanding of the fundamentals. Okay, those are my five tips that if I was to start over, start from scratch learning how to code, these are the things that I would really implement or try to implement. It's easy to say that you would, but when you're in those shoes or in that position of learning something so new, it's really easy to feel like, to have that sense of overwhelming, or to feel like you're never going to get to where you want to be. But really keep these tips in mind, because they will truly help you in your coding journey and get ahead a little bit. Thank you all for watching this video. I hope you found it very valuable and helpful. Make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related videos. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it valuable, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.